You're watching NBC4, connected to you. Live from the area's leading news station, this is News 4 at 5.
There's some housing help on the way. Late this afternoon, the House of Representatives approved a sweeping bill to help the struggling housing industry. The measure is on track to pass the Senate and become law within days. Treasury Secretary Henry Paulson says the bill will send a strong message to investors and help the country turn the corner on the housing crisis. The bill will help thousands of homeowners facing foreclosure. They'll now be able to obtain new and cheaper loans if lenders agree. The bill will offer government help to troubled mortgage lenders Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac. And the legislation will provide nearly $4 billion in grants to neighborhoods hit hardest by foreclosures. President Bush initially opposed this provision, but dropped his opposition this morning, clearing the way for passage of the bill. The bill also calls for some tax breaks that include up to $7,500 for first-time buyers.
However, despite the efforts by Congress to stem the growing foreclosure crisis, that new bill does not address homeowners who are struggling with subprime or predatory loans. Tens of thousands of worried homeowners crammed the Capitol Hilton today to get help from a community advocacy group that works to restructure loans. Jane Wattrell is in our newsroom now with more on that story. Jane?
Well, Jim, the group is called NACA, the Neighborhood Assistance Corporation of America. And for the past 5 days, their volunteers have worked tirelessly to help restructure thousands of loans and keep people in their homes.
These are the faces of the desperate, thousands of working people who are on the brink of foreclosure.
Serious, yeah, it's extreme. People are losing their homes and it's not a good thing. You know, no one wants to lose anything that they own.
For the past 5 days, struggling homeowners line the halls of this Washington hotel, taking advantage of a free loan restructuring event put on by NACA, a nonprofit home ownership organization.
We verify the documents and then we come up with a payment that they can afford. And then we send that to the lender and say, this homeowner cannot afford any more than that.
Initially, 5,000 people signed up to work with counselors, but word quickly spread, bringing out 15,000 more. Hundreds had to be turned away, like Myra Riggs of Brandywine.
Well, I mean, you had people from Ohio, Florida, I mean, across the state that came to try to save their homes. A lot of them are already homes written to foreclosure. They're fighting so it doesn't go into auction.
Kim Nguyen of Alexandria waited in line for 2 days before seeing a counselor to restructure her loan. NACA helped cut her $6,000 monthly mortgage payment in half.
I am really relieved, and I hope people know more about this and people believe in this, and I really believe in this.
NACA says an event like this destroys the myth that homeowners are walking away from lenders. All they need, they say, is someone to help.
Imagine saving $800 a month, $2,000 a month, going from 11%, 10% interest rate to 2%, 4%, and 5%. Knowing that you don't have to move your kids, that's powerful.
NACA has offices in Washington and Baltimore and is open to anyone who wants to come in. They also have a website. It's NACA.com. Jim?
Jane Wattrell. Thank you, Jane.